Day starts with a coffee and ends with a wine. Takes forever in getting ready, so she's never on time for anything. When she gets that come get me look in her eyes, well, it kinda scares me the way that she drives me wild. And she drives me wild. She dances, ain't afraid to take chances, and wears her heart on her sleeve. Yeah, she's crazy, but her crazy's beautiful to me. She makes plans for the weekend, can't wait to go out, till she changes her mind, says let's stay on the couch and watch TV. She falls asleep. Beautiful, crazy, she can't help but amaze me. The way that she dances, ain't afraid to take chances, and wears her heart on her sleeve. Yeah, she's crazy, but her crazy's beautiful to me.
Rejoicing into the house of the Lord for this celebration. Dear brothers and sisters, we now stand with Meghan and Matthew on the day they intend to form a home of their own as husband and wife. For them, this is a moment of unique importance, so let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and our prayer. As their brothers and sisters, let us listen attentively with them to the Word of God who speaks to us today, and then with the Holy Church, humbly pray to God our Father through Christ, our Lord. for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these your servants, Matthew and Meghan. Come together before your altar that they may be confirmed in love with one another. We pray this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We sing to God's glory.
First reading is a reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild birds and various animals, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. But none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man. And while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love. That is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so also I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another, as I have loved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, our liturgy of words today, we read from Genesis, from creation, where God creates the man and the woman. They were made for each other. And the declaration, this one at last, this is the one. And very often when people decide to get married, they kind of echo that in their heart and their soul. This is the one. I have found the one I meant to spend my life with. And we realize that it's all part of God's plan for the world. It's all part of his plan for us. And not only that we will find happiness on earth, but more than that, that we will find glory in heaven. And so on the way there, on the way to the kingdom that Jesus came to reveal, we have these experiences of love. Some particular experiences of love call people, like Meghan and Matthew, to make a covenant of love, to promise a unique
kind of love for each other that is only for this other person, this one, at last. And so we celebrate today what we call in the Catholic Church holy matrimony, the difference between being married between a civil official and an official of the Church is that we call God into it. We call for the Lord to make this a holy matrimony, one that is bound by the love of Christ. And so we celebrate this wedding today on the weekend when the Church celebrates the Holy Family. And I have good news for you, because this Mass is at 1 p.m., you still get to go to Mass for Sunday. Isn't that great? You can get up tomorrow, or you can go tonight, I don't know what time you're going to the reception. I always like to make that announcement, see if anybody smiles. Except me, we can't go to Mass again. Holy Family is what we celebrate. It's Jesus and Mary and Joseph. And I would say that this young couple both already know the experience of a holy family, of people of faith in their families, of couples who were parents and grandparents who showed them what love in marriage is, so that they can find in their own heart and soul a complete commitment to this person that they marry, a complete commitment for life, because God, who is eternal, gives us his grace and his love. It teaches us how to get better and better at it as we age. This couple is, they're both 27 years old. I told them when I met with them a couple weeks ago, I said, I think I have shoes that are 27 years old. That just makes me feel old, but reminds me how young you are. And there's nothing more beautiful than young love and young people who know what God's will is for them as they begin this life as husband and wife today. I didn't know Matthew as long as I know Meghan, because Meghan's father and my brother went to high school together and been friends for many years. And I found that Matthew works in construction. He builds roadways and bridges. And I said, oh, that's a great metaphor for marriage. Building roadways and building bridges. Because when two human beings need to communicate with each other, sometimes you have to plow out the roadway. Get some old feelings out of the way and offer forgiveness. And sometimes you need to be the one who starts to build the bridge. I think in marriage, the ideal bridge is when both sides of the valley are building out toward them and meet in the center. Just like the unity candle that they'll light after they take their vows and exchange their rings. They take the light from both candles on the side and they meet in the middle. They meet in the center. Because the two of them come together as one in God's sight today, as equals. And Meghan's way of making a living is teaching the Montessori school system, and she is a teacher for God's special children. And so it takes great skills of communication in any kind of teaching. I give teachers a lot of credit. There's they do it all those hours every day. I go in the classroom for 15 minutes and I'm looking at the clock. Teacher, you want the class back now? I've run out of things to say. It doesn't happen when I'm preaching, it only happens when I'm in a classroom. Put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bearing with one another, forgiving one another. This is actually the second reading for Mass. We'll hear it when we go back to Mass this weekend for the Holy Family. This is the second reading for this beautiful feast day we celebrate, because it's about being like God in the way that we love. A higher love. And when you love sacrificially, when you love that other person enough to make the ultimate sacrifice for them, put your own agenda aside and ask, what do you want, dear, on a regular basis? That's sacrificial love. It's hard for us as humans to put our own list of wants aside and ask what the other one wants. But there's a joy that you see in happily married couples when they do what the other one wants. And they say, I don't need to see that movie. Oh, a movie with monsters? And yeah, that's what all the girls want to go see. Yeah. Or, oh, a love story? Sure, honey, we'll go. Then couples sometimes keep score. I went to three of your monster movies. You've got to go see another love story with me. I've heard those conversations back. As the Father loves me, I love you, Jesus says. And so that sacrificial love, that life-giving love that we call marriage, is what Jesus wants. Jesus Christ is the bridegroom of the church, and the church is his bride. And so we all can grow in holiness, no matter what our vocation, no matter what our age, even if you don't have shoes that are older than our bridegroom today. We can grow in holiness because God, in his eternal love, continues to pour out his grace, his blessings on us. We are his children. We are his beloved children. And we can only imagine the joy in God's heart when two of his beloved children come together today and make their promises in God's presence and ask for the Lord's help and grace and exchange their rings, which represent the eternal love of God, binding them as one. We pray, of course, for many happy, holy years of matrimony for Matthew and Meghan. It starts today, 28th of December 2019, here at Community Heaven Church in the presence of God. Dearly beloved, we have come together here before a minister of this church in the presence of this community so that your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacramental seal, and your love will be enriched with his blessing, so that you may have strength to be faithful to each other forever and to assume the responsibilities of married life. So in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions to these three questions. Meghan and Matthew, have you come here freely and without reservation to enter into marriage?
We have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other as long as you both shall live?
We are.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the laws of Christ and his church?
We do.
Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, turn toward each other, join your hands, and declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Matthew, take you, Meghan, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
Hi, Meghan. Take you, Matthew, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
May the Lord, in his kindness, strength, and consent you have declared before the church, graciously bring to fulfillment his blessings within you. When God has joined, let no one divide. And now bless the rings. Bless, O Lord, these rings which we bless in your name, so that those who wear them may remain eternally faithful to each other, abide in peace and in your will, and live always in mutual charity through Christ our Lord.
Meghan, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Matthew, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Congratulations.
Love in your hearts forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all married couples here today be reminded of the joy of their own day. May they give thanks for the happiness they have known, and may each day find them more devoted to each other than the last. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the protection of all police, firefighters, first responders, and those in the armed forces who risk their lives daily to ensure our safety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we gather to celebrate this joyful day, we remember the faithful departed whom we have loved, especially James Abney, Kathleen Doherty, Samuel Abney, Donald and Jean Gorman, Michael Willis, Ryan Purcell, and James Quinlan. May they watch over us today and join with us in love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Set in place the beginning of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ to his church, O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace and love of peace abide in your daughter, Meghan, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Matthew, entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments made one in the flesh, that they may be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all, that they may be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents and live to see their children's children. And grant them reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope. May they come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of that peace. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now it is my distinct privilege to remember that I forgot that the cup is going to bring some flowers to the Blessed Mother. Introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Matthew Admiral.
Thank you so much for all your guidance over the years to help get us to this day. You're the real reasons that we are all here. Secondly, I want to thank the wedding party. There's a reason that Matt and Meghan chose all of you to be here today. Matt and Meghan, you both look amazing tonight. Matt, you particularly look much sharper when you dressed up as Scooby-Doo and teach us songs. They played the Scooby-Doo theme song there, and he did not take that too well, so sorry about that. Growing up, Matt and I were practically attached to him. We do everything together. We were so close, we shared everything from friends to hockey teams. I couldn't imagine anyone else but us. Anytime I was having fun, Matt, you were right there with me. The only time Matt and I really worked together was during college years. That didn't really stop the celebration for me too long. Matt would usually come and visit every week. It was during one perfect weekend in Fredonia that Matt met the love of his life. I could tell right then and there, by the way he was talking about Megan, he was crazy. So crazy that he would drive through blizzards with his crappy Ford Focus Through countless dinners, concerts, parties, and nights out, Matt and Megan's relationship grew into something great. It was only a matter of time until Matt asked Megan to be his wife. Matt, thank you for being such a stable force in my life, a great friend, and even a great brother. I know they say that the younger brother is supposed to live up to the older one, but in this case, it couldn't be farther from the truth. Matt, you are someone I strive to be on a daily basis, someone I've always looked up to for inspiration, and today is no exception. Megan, I think we can all agree you're starting to. And Matt, you love it. From our time together for a moment, when you call me your big brother, to now when I actually become your big brother. It's been an amazing journey, and I can't wait for the future. As I begin to wrap up, I want to leave Matt with some words of encouragement and something to look forward to. A real man never stops trying to show his woman how much he needs, even after he's here. And most importantly, happy wife, happy life. And Megan, I know this is ultra corny, but any home can be a castle and a king in the heart of love. Matt and Megan, tonight we celebrate you, and we're getting such a beautiful new family today. We all wish you a lifetime of happiness, love, health, success, and laughter. May you continue to find humor in the bad and appreciate the good for your friendship and to continue to grow your love for each other. So everyone, please raise your glass for the M&Ms.
Good evening, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my mom, Megan's little sister.
Woo!
As I sat down to write my speech, I thought of all the fun memories I've had with Megan from our childhood. From encouraging my at-home haircuts to our shoving various items up my nose. Big sister, little sister relationship. It's safe to say that as much as we butt heads growing up, she's still the person I look up to. Theoretically, because I'm the taller sibling. You can't really look up to But in all seriousness, I've lucked out in the sister category. Megan, you taught me more. Yeah, my 22 years of life, you know. You've been amazing. You've been an amazing role model, even that best friend. No matter where we are in life, even when I'm in Cleveland, you have been there for me, no matter what's happening. And I know you will continue to be there for me because you're my big sister through it all. I get a little bit more painful to hang you by my side as I grow up. And I can't even have your leg to stand by your side. I've always wondered if it was me, the lucky guy, taking to marry the McCormick Madness. Would he be able to handle Megan's love of food, her sarcasm, how she's always willing and never stopping, and did I even mention her love of food? And I came along with the perfect compliment to Megan. He keeps her unconditionally happy, he keeps her grounded, and he loves her. And he didn't know it right away, but as time went on, I saw that Matthew was a perfect match for not only my sister, but our family. I had no doubt in my mind that you will continue to love my sister and make her the happiest person to show her all the love in the world. I didn't think of today as you marrying my sister. Rather, you're officially becoming a member of our family and you couldn't be happier to be my brother. Meghan, Matt, you're starting a new chapter in your lives together today. And I couldn't think of two more deserving people. I've been lucky enough to watch the two of you grow up together and form an unbreakable bond. What two of you have is something very special. And I know that from today and forward, you will continue to love each other endlessly. Meghan and Matthew love you both very much. So cheers to the new Mr. and Mrs. Matthew.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Matthew and his mother. I think this is T. Carter's mother's song.
Just a couple of things.
Beautiful, crazy, she can't help.